Central Intelligence centers around Calvin Joyner, played by comedian Kevin Hart. After he reconnects with an awkward pal from high school through Facebook, Bob Stone, who's played by Dwayne Johnson, a mild-mannered accountant who's lured into the world of international espionage. But even with these two A-list actors, this movie, like all others, are bound to make a mistake or two. Hello everyone, welcome back to Movie Mistakes, and today we're going to show you 10 mistakes we found in Central Intelligence. Spilled coffee. In the first mistake, Calvin is at work having a cup of coffee. He accidentally spills his cup of coffee while arranging some papers. But just after he picks up the cup, the camera changes angles, and we can now see that the coffee stain on the rug has changed shape. Why the director didn't just go with the original coffee spill is still a mystery. Where's my menu? Near the beginning of the movie, Bob and Calvin are in a bar, having a few beers and reminiscing about high school. Notice the menu on the table just under Bob's right hand. But as the camera changes angles, we can now see that the menu is no longer on the table. I guess he didn't like what they were serving. The gun drop. In the scene where Bob visits Calvin at his office, the CIA has them cornered with nowhere to run. Just then, we witness Bob drop his gun and hit Calvin in the head. But as they make their escape toward the window, Bob conveniently has another gun. Self-cleaning shirt. Just after the two make their getaway, Calvin is freaking out about being shot at. Bob realizes they have car trouble and goes underneath the truck to fix it. When he finally gets off of the dirty ground of his abandoned warehouse, his shirt doesn't have a speck of dirt on it. Therapy, anyone? In mistake number 5, Bob pretends to be Calvin's therapist. As part of the session, Bob kisses Calvin, which forces him to freak out, revealing an empty spot on the couch. Calvin tells Maggie they're leaving, but in the next shot of Bob, a pair of glasses appears on the couch. Glasses or not? Anyone who has ever had therapy knows that it's not all fun and games. So, in the same scene, Bob can be seen with his glasses in hand. But several times during this scene, we can see them disappear and reappear as the camera switches back and forth. Magical chips. Bob is finally caught by the CIA with Calvin's help. Calvin is then locked in the CIA break room, and the agent grabs a red bag of chips. There's nothing unusual about a hungry CIA agent, but what is unusual is the same red bag of chips is back in its original position. I guess he didn't want them after all. Book and cup. Calvin helps Bob to escape the CIA building, and they're looking for a plane to steal. As Calvin distracts the guy at the counter, take note of the position of his book and cup. When we get a shot of the two from a different angle, notice they are now in different spots.
Shit?
Oh, shit.
I'm just kidding. This is my friend.
Band-Aid made. Calvin and Bob stop the bad guys, save the world, and arrive at their class reunion in style. Earlier, Bob shoots Calvin in the neck, which is now covered by this Band-Aid. But during his conversation with Maggie, you can see that his Band-Aid is now missing. Letterman jacket jinx. At the end of the movie, Bob finally gives Calvin back his Letterman jacket from high school, as you can see here with the writing on it. The camera then switches angles, and the letters are on the opposite side as well. Did you see any mistakes in Central Intelligence that we didn't see? If so, let us know in the comments section below. Don't forget to let us know what you'd like to see next. Thanks for stopping by, and we'll see you next week.